mean, hey, something's got to be done about this assault on a commentator. He's doing his job.
Well, I agree with you, but you know the show's
this contest set for one fall is for the Divas Championship. Currently in the ring, the challenger from Scottsdale, Arizona, Nikki Bella.
It's obviously not a good idea to even try to talk to Brock Lesnar.
I mean, the guy shows up when he wants to, and then he just assaults the man trying to do his job. That's what it's been like for a couple of weeks now since Lesnar's been back.
From Buffalo, New York, she is the current Divas Champion, the Glamazon, Phoenix.
Nikki Bella really earning this opportunity here tonight for the Divas title after what happened a couple of weeks ago on Friday Night SmackDown. Beth Phoenix taking on Nikki Bella. And Kelly coming down, causing a bit of distraction for Beth. And well, you can't blame Nikki. She really takes advantage of the situation here.
Beth Phoenix took her eye off the ball or off the Diva there for a minute. And she paid the price.
You know, last week on WWE.com, Beth Phoenix telling Nikki that she will grant her request for a Divas title match up here tonight. Beth Phoenix closing in on one of the longest reigns ever as a Divas champion. She's at 205 days, 213 days, the actual record. So Beth Phoenix looking to extend that here tonight on Monday Night Raw against Nikki Bella.
Ordinarily, I'd be smiling ear to ear. A good move for a Diva matchup. And man, Brock Lesnar is just a buzzkill. Oh, no. Speaking of that.
As newly appointed executive administrator to Mr. John Laurinaitis, it is now my responsibility to do whatever I can to improve our shows. Considering the Bella Twins' tendency to cheat, combined with the amount of other divas who sit around here doing absolutely nothing, John Laurinaitis has approved my suggestion to make this championship match a Lumberjill match.
Well, I can't complain about that. We're going to add more divas to the situation.
So what's going to happen is these divas will surround the ring. Their job is to make sure the competitors get back into the ring if they happen to fall outside or otherwise decide to take a break during this matchup. So again, the Divas Championship on the line. Beth Phoenix defending against Nikki Bella in what is now a Lumberjill matchup. But again, just to briefly get back to the situation involving Brock Lesnar, the point I was trying to make before is Sheamus is fined $500,000, $500,000 by our general manager, John Laurinaitis, for striking a referee. It's going to be interesting to see what type of action he takes on Lesnar after what he did to Matthews here tonight.
Well, I think that there's no doubt that if John Laurinaitis is, you know, all about power to the people, something definitely is going to have to be done to Brock Lesnar.
Nikki Bella off the drop kick, taking it to Beth Phoenix here with the Divas title.
Wow.
Ouch. Up for grabs. We saw a couple of weeks ago, Nikki can knock off the Bella Twins. And look at the number one trend worldwide right now on Twitter, the world talking about what just happened to Josh Matthews.
Well, ordinarily, Josh Matthews would love to be trending worldwide, but believe me, that's the wrong way. You don't want to be trending that way.
Brock Lesnar, he just seems to do what he wants when
he wants around here. Look at the strength of Beth Phoenix here. He's showing off her power to the world.
Whoa! One of the reasons she's held the Divas Championship over 200 days.
One of these lovely divas at ringside here. Ooh.
Come on now. Beth now punishing Nikki Bella.
Your eyes on the action. Ooh. I better watch these divas closely at ringside.
Oh, I'm sure that's what you're doing. Cover by Beth, hooks the leg, and Nikki at two manages to get the shoulder up. Looking over the shoulder of Kelly and Alicia Fox.
When I see Kelly, it reminds me I'm an old-fashioned romantic. You know, flowers, candy, love poems. But she hadn't sent me any of those, so I guess there's no future. You know.
And Beth continuing to wear down Nikki Bella. Kelly, of course, who's had her differences with Beth in the past. Beth, who took the Divas Championship from Kelly back in the fall of last year.
Oh, man. Beth Phoenix is so powerful. Well, she'll just grab her.
That's why she's called the Glamazon.
I almost want to say manhandle, but it's a diva handle at the hands of Beth Phoenix. These matches are fun to watch.
Beth just, she systematically takes, picks her opponent's part. And Nikki trying to fight back into this. Great opportunity here tonight for Nikki Bella. Alicia Bree was once a Divas champion.
It's actually, well, that actually turned out to be a good move.
And look at Nikki trying for an upset here. Hook of the leg of the Glamazon. Ooh, and Beth Phoenix just narrowly escapes near fall for Nikki.
All these lumberjills around the ring. You know, it seems like the majority of them are pulling for,
Oh, man.
Like pulling against Beth.
And now the lumberjills are supposed to, Beth Phoenix landing a
ankle or knee.
Right off the apron.
That's just an ankle.
The lumberjills are supposed to be getting the competitors back in the ring now.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Well, you see Brie Bella, Nikki's sister, in no hurry. She's on the other side. And now Beth Phoenix looking to take control. And oh, look out. Brie Bella did not take too kindly to that. And here we go.
Yeah, well, this is what we're supposed to be seeing out of these lumberjills.
What? Ganging up on the Divas champion?
Yeah.
No, they're not. They're supposed to be putting him back into the ring, is that's what their job is.
Have you ever explained what this whole concept is about?
Yeah, twice at least.
The Canadian lumber camps, if two lumberjacks had a disagreement and they wanted to have a fight, they didn't have a ring, so they just circled a bunch of lumberjacks around, and if they got thrown out, they'd throw them back
there
in. What's happening here?
There are no lumberjacks in the Canadian camps that look like these women surrounding the ring.
That's why they saw lumberjills, you idiot.
Stop this right now. Can you continue? Can you continue, Beth? Right?
Phoenix is really favoring that angle. And Nikki Bella from behind. Rolling Beth Phoenix up, shoulders down. Oh, she did it! She did it! Beth Phoenix said she could continue, and Nikki Bella took advantage.
Divas champion.
Oh, man!
Nikki Bella.
Nikki Bella wins the Divas championship, ending the over 200-day reign of Beth Phoenix.
Look at Nikki Bella. It looks like she's making love to that championship.
Beth cannot believe she lost, and more importantly, you have to wonder how serious the ankle injury to Beth Phoenix is.
Well, obviously it is serious, but what a surprise. There's the trainer checking on her right now. What a surprise we have. I mean, Beth Phoenix just on the verge of becoming the longest reigning Divas champion in WWE history, and now that's come to an end here tonight.
Well, you can't blame Nikki Bella, I guess, for taking advantage of the situation. We've got a new Divas champion in Nikki Bella.
Congratulations, Nikki.